The Smithsonian has a quite remarkable collection of orchids. It's an exciting group of plants. All of them have their own stories, and some of them are really, really interesting, bizarre stories. There's a bunch of orchids behind me right now. If you look at them, none of them look anything like any of the others that are there. They look completely different from each other. And they look the way they do specifically to attract whatever it is that pollinates it. There's this whole array of orchids that are very three-dimensional, that have all kinds of structures, and you can't really flatten them out and look at them on any particular, you know, from a frontal view and get the picture of an orchid. The orchid that we scanned was a plant of Embreea Heron Husana, which is a very strange and rare orchid in cultivation. We scanned it not just because it's a big, beautiful flower, but because of it's kind of a bit of like a torture chamber for its bee pollinator. It's a male euglossine bee that collects fragrances from flowers in order to attract females. And so where does that come from? And I don't think that anybody's ever really explored that. So this is a chance to really get a very, very good idea of the structures that might exist within the flower and maybe a key to how they're produced in the first place. The male bee that collects the broadest array of fragrances, the most complex array of fragrances, is the one that gets all the action from the ladies. So what happens is the bee approaches the flower. Often several competing male bees will come, and they'll land on the lip. The lip is a very fleshy thing with horns. It's a crazy looking structure, which you'll be able to see in the scan. And as they're jostling around and they're trying to scrape fragrances that are being secreted by glands in the lip, they end up falling through the flower. They literally fall. And as they fall, they pick up the pollinia on their backs, kind of surreptitiously. They don't even know it's there. And then they fly off to another flower some distance away while they're searching for more fragrances, and end up depositing that pollen on another plant, cross-pollinating in the population, which is the goal. How wonderful would it be to be able to do a huge 3D print of an orchid that, say, a child could crawl through it, just like as if he was a pollinator himself? He could have that same experience of crawling through the flower and understanding on a very visceral level what that means and what a pollinator does and what a flower is. I hope that we do inspire not just interest in orchids, but also stewardship of the environment as a result. Because again, once you get involved with orchids and you understand what they are and how interconnected they are, it leads you to be a steward of the environment.